The coalition of united political parties has blamed the Independent National Electoral Commission for the inconclusive governorship poll in Anambra State. CUPP, in a statement by its spokesperson, Barrister Chukwudi Ezeobika, alleged that the electoral umpire failed in its duties to conduct a hitch-free governorship election in Anambra State. The statement, which questioned INEC's preparations for the 2023 general elections, said it has become imperative to ask such questions if the electoral body has so many challenges in conducting the Anambra governorship election, which is an off-season and single poll. He argued that the failure of the BVAS machines in many polling units has exposed the incompetences of INEC and its workers. The Independent National Electoral Commission had, in the early hours of Monday, declared the November 6th governorship election in Anambra State inconclusive. The returning officer for the gubernatorial election, Professor Florence Ubi, made the announcement at the INEC head office in Awka, Anambra State capital, stating that there was no election in Ihiala, local government area of the state. Motorists in Kano State are experiencing fuel scarcity as long queues have resurfaced at filling stations in the state. According to reports, the majority of the filling stations visited within the metropolitan area were on lock, under lock and key. Now, the investigation further revealed the only filling station were selling at the control price of 165 naira per litre. The situation was, however, characterized by long queues and filling stations selling only one or two pumps to customers in spite of the long queues. The situation outside Kano metropolitan area is not different, as majority of the stations outside Kano city remained closed, while a few ones operating were selling at above government approved price. A lot of motorists were left with no option than to purchase fuel from black marketers at higher prices, ranging from 1,000 naira to 1,500 naira per 4 liters gallon, depending on the location. The Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation Limited, NNPC, says Nigerians should not panic over fuel scarcity, as there are over 1.7 billion of it. Now, the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation Limited has asked Nigerians not to panic over fuel scarcity, as there are over 1.7 billion liters of petrol in stock. In a statement signed by the NNPC spokesman Garba Dean Mohammed, the national oil company said it was unnecessary to entertain any fear of scarcity of petrol throughout this festive season and beyond. According to the statement, the NNPC has over 1.7 billion liters of petrol in stock and more products expected to arrive into the country daily over the coming weeks or months. The Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, is set to hold the third Capital Market Committee, CMC, meeting in 2021 from Thursday, November 11th to Friday, 12th, 2021. The meeting is scheduled to be held virtually through Zoom with key stakeholders in the capital market meeting on November the 11th, while the usual interface with press on the outcome of the CMC meeting will take place on Friday, November the 12th. During the meeting, issues bordering on implementation of the 10-year capital market master plan, implementation of the fintech roadmap, the commodities trading ecosystem roadmap, as well as other salient matters relating to the capital market and the economy, would be discussed. The CMC was primarily established to serve as a medium for exchange of ideas among market stakeholders, as well as a venue for providing feedback to the SEC on how to continuously address challenges, improve market operations, and enhance the regulatory framework. President Nasri Idris of the National Union of Teachers, or NUT, says the federal government's proposed a new salary structure would help teachers perform better. He also called for the creation of a body that would settle teachers' payment of salaries. Now, Idris said Nigerian teachers had been demoralized due to poor service, and many others quit the profession out of frustration. He condemned the poor treatment the country's primary school teachers received. According to Idris, some states pay secondary school teachers their salaries on minimum wage, but not in primary schools. NUT, however, advocates and supports the removal of teachers from the local governments and the creation of a body akin to the Universal Basic Education Board or National Primary Education Commission during the military era. Armed bandits have reportedly killed 6 persons and abducted many others during an attack in Regia village in Guzao local government area of Zamfara state. According to an eyewitness, the bandits went from house to house collecting food items and other things they needed. A resident, Mustafa Ibrahim, narrated on phone that the bandits stormed the community late Sunday afternoon. According to him, the bandits also went from house to house collecting food items and other things they needed. He added that during the house-to-house search, the bandits also took several other people with them. Another source spoke to BBC Hausa also confirmed the attack. He said those who died would be buried on Monday, while those injured are in hospital. Now, Governor of Lagos State Babajide Sanwo-Olu has been named as the winner of the 2020 Zik Prize for Good Governance. Sanwo-Olu shared the prize with Abdullahi Sule, Governor of Nasarawa State. The Lagos State Governor was honored with the award in recognition of his strong commitments to transforming Lagos into a mega city using the themes, the developmental agenda, while quietly bringing back Lagos State as the center of excellence. The Public Policy Research and Analysis Center has sometime in September 2021 at a press conference in Lagos formally announced the winners of the year 2020 Zik Prize in Leadership Awards in different categories. Sanwo-Olu on Monday, November the 8th, 2021, took to his Instagram page to share the news and photos from the event. Oyo State and French governments have held talks on ways of leveraging existing bilateral relationships to boost the economy of the state. Governor Sheyi Makinde of Oyo State, while receiving the French ambassador Emmanuel Blattman and her team on a courtesy visit to him, the executive council chambers of the governor's office in Ibadan, equally expressed his determination to make the state the first investment destination in Nigeria.
Involved in Oyo State through actions and programs by the French Agency for Development, and also the French Treasury will be having for the first time in Nigeria and the first time in the health sector a big partnership with Oyo State in order to help on the health aspects and the health facilities. And so what do I expect for the future? And after this very warm welcome I have received here from His Excellency Governor of Oyo State and all his team and the distinguished guests that were here today, well, is to enhance all our relations in every sector, you know, not only with exchanges for youth, academic, new projects, but also in the fields of economy, trade, and development.
So, we do have challenges with medical tourism in Nigeria, to the extent that a few weeks ago, the governor of the central bank also cried out and said that Nigeria's foreign reserves have been depleted because of medical tourism. With this facility from the French government, we believe that Oyo State will definitely be able to bridge the gap nationally as far as medical tourism is concerned. They will be coming to Oyo State once they have confidence in the facilities and also
As part of efforts to discover sport talents and expand the state economy through sporting activities, the Oyo State government has partnered a Sport Development Foundation, Advocate for Grassroots Sports Foundation, to explore and showcase the state's sports potential to the outside world. The State Commissioner for Youth and Sport, Sheun Fakorede, made this known during a press conference held in his office.
Man City was showing us what they've got. They're showing us the number of fans they have in Nigeria, the number of, you know, engagement they have every weekend in Nigeria. So when it was our time, 3 years to show them, we were just speculating, but it didn't happen. So from then onwards, I decided that if that's the only thing I do before I leave this world, we must make sure that will collate data. And Madame said it is for fans. It goes beyond fans now. If you remember when we have a little meeting with Honorable Commissioner said, no, you must not stop there. You must have for coaches, you must have for parents. But you know what this database will do for us? Let's say, for instance, 2022 Qatar that is coming up. You went to the embassy to apply for your visa. You're from Oyo State. They don't know you. They'll be wondering, who is this person again? You know, okay, yeah. But you know what? They will come to our portal and search your name. And they will see your name. That is almost automatic visa for you. Because you're registered with a state-sanctioned portal. Your name is on a database.
Because today, there is no way you want to talk anywhere in the world that the English the world understand, the lexicon the world understand today is data. Data is king. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can't come and just tell me that, okay, we want you to sponsor our community. We want you to do this for our community in sports. I mean, I want to hear figures. Mm-hmm. That, okay, in our community, I'm from Ibarapa Central Local Government, for example now. So if I want to talk data, if I want to tell people about that community, I should be able to say that in my I have so number of athletes, you know, I have so number of footballers, I have so number of tennis players, I have so number of Scrabble or chess players.